Hello children, today I will teach chapter 2 in science. The name of the chapter is Human Body. Let's see what I am reading now and explain you. Every living thing is made up of one or more cells. A cell is the smallest unit of the body. So, cell is a structural and functional unit of a life, that is called a cell. The human body is made up of millions of cells. So, our human body is made up of thousands and thousands of cells. Many cells together make a tissue. So, tissue is a group of cells together that makes a tissue. Tissue forms organ. Organs and organs together form an organ system. The human body is made up of different organs that do different types of work. An organ system is a group of organs that work together to perform one or more functions. The respiratory system, skeletal system, muscular system, digestive system, circulatory system, and excretory system are some organ systems in the human body. In this chapter, we shall study respiratory system in detail. So you can see now internal organs. Human body. Human body is made up of several organs and organ system that have special purposes to serve. These special purposes are called functions. Organs are located at different places in human body. So I am talking about a human body. Human body is made up of many organs and organ system and has a special purposes to serve and has a specific reasons to serve. The special purposes are called function. So organs are located at different places in human body. And our brain, it is located inside the head. It helps us to think. It sends messages to different parts of the body and tells them to work. So brain is situated inside our head and also helps us to think. And sends messages, it gives message communication to the different parts of the body. And also it tells them to work. So brain is an important part of our body. Now we'll see heart. It lies in the middle of the chest cavity. Heart is situated in the middle of the chest cavity. Chest cavity is the second largest hollow space of the body. That is called chest cavity. And it pumps blood to various organs of the body. Blood is carried through blood vessels. So, and what happens? Heart pumps blood to various organs, to the different parts of our body, and blood is also carried through our blood vessel. Blood vessel is what? It's a tube that transports blood through your body. That is called blood vessels. Stomach and intestine. We eat food through our mouth. With the help of food pipe, the food reaches the stomach. From the stomach, the food goes to intestines. The stomach and the intestines are located inside our abdomen. Stomach and intestine break down food into simpler substances that our body can use. The breaking down of food into simpler substances which our body can use is called digestion. So here it is saying that we eat food through our mouth. From our mouth we eat, and with the help of food pipe, the food goes to the stomach. It reaches to our stomach, and from stomach, the food goes to intestine. Intestine is what? It's a long continuous tube running from the stomach to the anus. That is called intestine. It's coming from the stomach to anus. The stomach and the intestines are located inside our abdomen. So here, stomach and intestines are situated where? Inside our tummy. The stomach and intestine break down food into simpler substances. So stomach and intestines helps to break down the food, means into smaller particles that a body can use. The breaking down of food into simpler substances. See, this breaking down of food into small particles in our body is called digestion. So with the help of stomach and intestine, things take place. Now we'll see kidneys. There are two kidneys inside our abdomen. They purify the blood and produce urine. Urine is a waste product of our body. Yes, Singh, we have two kidneys in our tummy, and what it helps me, kidneys helps to purify the blood and also helps to produce our urine, and it is also called the waste product of our body. So kidney is very much important in our body. The skeletal system. The skeletal system of our body is made up of 206 bones. Bones are attached to each other with the help of muscles, which provide us movements. There are about 600 muscles in our body. This is a skeletal system in our body. The body is made up of 206 bones, and bones are attached to each other with the help of muscles, with the help of that group of tissues, and they are about 600 muscles in our body. Respiratory system. The nose, windpipe and lungs make up our respiratory system. So with the help of nose, windpipe and lungs comes together, that makes a respiratory system. Nose is there. We breathe in and breathe out through our nose. Breathing in is called inhalation and breathing out is called exhalation. So through our nose we breathe, and we are, when we take oxygen in our body, that is called inhalation, and when we take out that carbon dioxide, that is called exhalation. Windpipe. The air enters our body through nose. Passing through windpipes enters the lungs. So the air enters our body how? Through our nose, and it passes through windpipes and it goes to our lungs. Lungs. Lungs are located inside the chest cavity, one or each side. Lungs absorb oxygen from the inhaled air and remove carbon dioxide from the exhaled air. The air that we breathe in has more of oxygen, whereas air that we breathe out has more of carbon dioxide. A thin dome-shaped sheet of muscle called diaphragm separates the lungs from our stomach. When air is inhaled, the diaphragm contracts and moves downwards, and the diaphragm expands and pushes upwards when air is exhaled. So lungs, you can see it is located in our chest cavity, and lungs absorb oxygen from the inhaled air and remove carbon dioxide from the exhaled. What means, when we take oxygen, that comes in and we release carbon dioxide what we had inhaled. The air that we breathe in has more of oxygen, where air that we breathe out has more of carbon dioxide. So when we breathe in air, that we call oxygen, and when we breathe out, that we call carbon dioxide. We have a thin dome shaped sheet of muscle. Means thin dome means just a round shape of muscle we have, that is called diaphragm, that separates the lung from the stomach. So it is separated by the diaphragm, which is in a round shape in our stomach. When air is inhaled, the diaphragm contracts. So its function is there. When we take in air, diaphragm, what it does, it contracts and moves downwards, and the diaphragm expands and pushes upwards when the air is exhaled. When we give out air, then it expands. This is the function of this diaphragm. Deep breathing is a simple exercise which ensures that more oxygen is taken in during inhalation. It is practiced during yoga or meditation. Means deep breathing is a it is one form of exercise. Means when we breathe in, that we take in oxygen, and that is called inhalation. And when we breathe out, that is called exhalation. We do during the yoga and meditations. Meditation is what? We are concentrating on one particular thing, that is called meditation. Process is this: sit down comfortably on a mat, slowly take a deep breath in through your nose, let the air completely fill your lungs. At the same time, let your belly expand by a few inches. This allows the lungs to expand completely. Next, try to breathe out fully. During exhalation, the expanded belly will collapse and go in. In this process, your lungs contract fully and all the air is exhaled. So, this is a process, this is a system. When you do exercise, slowly they take a deep breath, breathe in through your nose and let the air completely fill your lungs. It will fill your lungs full of air. At the same time, your belly will also expand. It will come big by a few inches. And that means that allows the lungs to expand completely. After that, next try to breathe out fully. Then when you breathe out fully, during the exhalation, expanded belly will collapse. Means that will go out. In this process, your lungs contract fully and all the air go out. Air pollution. Air pollution occurs when gases, dust, particles, fumes or odor are introduced into the atmosphere in the way that makes it harmful to humans, plants and animals. There are two types of air pollution. First, naturally occurring events, example smoke and dust from volcanoes, dust storms and smokes from forest fires. Second, man-made activities, harmful gases from vehicles, factories and power stations. So you are talking about the air pollution happens when gas, dust particles or smokes that produce and odor are also introduced, that smells also comes out from that pollution into the atmosphere, and it's become harmful to humans and plants and animals to survive in this air pollution. And there are two types of air pollution are given here. That naturally air pollution takes place, how? Due to the smoke and dust from the volcanoes, that takes place due to natural way. Dust storms, smokes from the forest fires, that also happens due to natural way. Man-made activities, that is by the man. Harmful gases from the vehicles, means harmful gases that emits from the vehicles like buses, trucks, etc. And the factories also, that pollution comes out. That is the human activities. Causes: smoke as well as harmful gases released by industries and factories. Second is harmful gases and chemicals released from vehicles. Third, smoke released due to burning of solid waste such as garbage and wood. What will be the effects of this one? First, disease of lungs. Second, breathing problems, coughing, sneezing, headaches, etc. will occur. Number three, again breathing problems, coughing, sneezing, headaches, etc. So what will be the causes of the pollution? So that harmful gases will be released in the atmosphere from the industries and factories. What happens? What problems will take place? What effects? It will affect our health and we will suffer from the disease of lungs. Second, harmful gases and chemicals released from the vehicles. If these things happens, what happens? We will have the problems. It will affect our body and we will have breathing problems such as coughing, sneezing, headaches and headaches, etc. Next is again smoke released due to burning of solid waste from the garbage and wood. That also affects us and will lead to a breathing problem such as coughing, sneezing, headaches, etc. So there are few questions for you to write this one in your rough copy. Question number one, what is function? Second question is, what sends messages to different parts of the body? Third is, what pumps blood to various parts of the body? Number four, why should we do deep breathing? Number five, what is the function of diaphragm? Where is it located in our body? Number six, explain briefly the process of digestion and name the organs which are involved in digestion. Number seven, how many kidneys are there in our body? Name a waste product of our body. These answers you have to write in your rough copy. After that, I'll discuss in the class.